We will be ready. We are very aware of how big this is and what a huge event. It is the biggest thing that our city has ever done, but actually it's one of the biggest things that the UK has ever hosted as well, with the possible exception of the Olympics in 2012. But Glasgow is absolutely up to the task. We are a brilliant event city. In fact, we've just been voted the leading global festival and event city by the World Travel Organization. And although this is big, what we will do is scale up the expertise that we've already got. We are a city that has a reputation for being extremely welcoming, for being a place where events don't just happen to the city, they become part of the city for the period that they're there. And that's what makes them special in Glasgow. It's what makes the Glasgow event special. When we had the Commonwealth Games in 2014, it was widely agreed that it was the best ever Commonwealth Games. I think it's going to be the best ever COP. We're a small city on a global scale, but we are a city that is, we punch above our weight, and we are up for a challenge. We like a challenge, and this is going to be one of the biggest ones we've ever taken on. But we're going to be very proud to welcome the world to Glasgow. Do a global event like this, we will put people at the centre. So we'll turn our smallness into an advantage to make it feel perhaps more friendly and more inclusive at COP. But also our smallness is an advantage because we're a compact city. It's easy to get around. People will be able to walk from place to place, from venue to venue. It will be an active travel COP, not just a low carbon travel COP, but a healthy COP as well. So we do have challenges, but I think people will find it will be a different experience from COPs that they've attended before, but a very positive one. And our aim is that everyone will come away thinking that it's been a very well-run event, but more than that, that they've learned and gained something from the experience of being in Glasgow. Absolutely. We in Glasgow have set ourselves a target of being carbon neutral, net zero emissions by 2030. So it's challenging. We're a post-industrial city, and our physical shape as a city presents us with considerable challenges. But we believe, as one of the cities where the Industrial Revolution began, and a city that was built from the Industrial Revolution, from the beginnings of the human activity that caused climate change, we've got a moral obligation to show leadership in Glasgow. So we've set ourselves this challenge. Having COP and the opportunity of hosting COP allows us to leverage support and resource to accelerate some of our activities. Some of the things that we will do anyway, but get them done faster, so that by the time people arrive in Glasgow next November, they'll be able to see concrete, practical examples of activity to deliver change in a city, actual delivery of decarbonisation on the ground in a very real sense, whether that's in transport or in buildings or in greening and rewilding, whatever area it is, we want to have been able to show progress.